Can you see a path toward a resolution of this conflict?
Well, thus far, at least what publicly both sides have been saying, and quite honestly have been preparing for, is for this conflict to continue for quite some time. The Qataris have said, we are willing to negotiate on certain issues, but we will not compromise our sovereignty. The Emiratis and the Saudis have said, these are our demands. Meet them, or we will turn our backs from you, and you will be out of the Gulf Cooperation Council. There may be some area for negotiation over, for example, the presence of Hamas leaders in Qatar, members of the Muslim Brotherhood who reside there. But beyond that, some of the big asks, shutting down Al Jazeera, forcing the Qataris to pay compensation, forcing the closure of the Turkish base in Qatar, those things are absolute non-starters for the Qataris.
Stephen, is there a risk for Saudi Arabia of pushing Qatar too far? I mean, one of the things they've said is you really have to cut off diplomatic relations with Iran. If they really drive them out of the GCC, might the Qataris not just turn to Iran and form stronger ties? And what would that do to the balance of power within the Gulf?
Well, Qatar's foreign relations with the Iranians is actually a rather delicate balance. They do share this large dome of natural gas in the Persian Gulf, but at the same time, they're on different sides of, for example, the Syrian conflict. There's no indication thus far that the Qataris are thinking in the future about tightening their ties with the Iranians. They're certainly tightening their ties with the Turks, but there's no indication that they've given any thought beyond the immediacy of this crisis. What they're calling for is negotiations, lifting the sanctions, and then negotiating and hoping to find a sustainable solution. Regardless of how it comes out, Qatar is going to continue to be isolated, and there will be continued mistrust between the Qataris and its partners in the Gulf Cooperation Council.